So good morning, everyone. Already last day of Jam Beyond. Slowly waking up, probably all of you. I'm going to tell you how you can enrich your extensions with Joomla ACL support. Who is an extension developer? Okay, great. Who has already implemented ACL in their extension? Okay, I see some doubts. Let's see, it's get connected. Okay, short introduction. Who am I? I'm Sander Potje from the Netherlands. I have my own small company, do all kinds of Joomla things. I'm the developer of ACL Manager. Also involved with the community, locally and internationally. I will upload my slides on SlideShare anyway, so you don't have to write everything. This is enough, probably. They will be there in an hour online. So Joomla ACL. It took a while to get Joomla ACL in Joomla. We had already some ACL thing, but it was really basic. It was all fixed. In DrupalCon in October 2005, when Joomla was just forked from Mambo, Johan Jansen did a presentation and he told us more about the roadmap. And on the roadmap, we see that in version 1.2 there will be full ACL. Version 1.2 was planned for the first quarter of 2006. We all know that that never happened. We didn't have any version 1.2, also not version 1.1. Later on, a couple years later in 2008, we had version 1.5, still not full ACL. But then it took until last year, 2011, 1.6, we had full ACL, which we could completely configure. What is ACL? ACL is Access Control List, it stands for. And in Joomla, we can divide it in kind of two different areas. One of the areas is to allow access to certain information on the website. That's more based on the front end, so who's able to see which article, which menu item, which module. That's the kind of ACL part in Joomla. And the other part is user actions on objects. So who's able to create items, delete items, or contact persons, etc. And this is the area we're mainly focusing on today, on how you can get those user actions in your extensions. A short introduction for how the ACL system works in Joomla 2.5. We can see this in an overview. This is a kind of summary of the entire Joomla ACL. We have a user, we have core permissions, we have a group, and we have access level. Let's look closely in each of them. The user first. It's good to know that the guest is also seen as a user. It's not as an account, but is a user at all. And the big difference between 1.5 and 2.5 is that we can assign users to multiple user groups. So not only one. No, we can assign them to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And that makes it kind of complicated because the settings will be merged in the actual setting at the end for the user. Another thing is the core permissions. The so-called actions. We have 10 in Joomla, 2.5 at the moment. Those are the site login, the admin login, and the offline access. Those are the kind of access actions. The offline access wasn't there before 1.7. That's introduced in 1.7, so you can now define who's able to log in on your website when it's turned offline. Then we have the super admin, and the super admin is only available on the global configuration. And when you set the super admin, that means that's the kind of super administrator we know from Joomla 1.5, and this user group is able to do anything, regardless of any setting. So that's kind of overruling everything. So once you set the super admin, they can do anything on the website. Later on, I will explain the level system, the kind of inheriting between the levels. But the superadmin is only available in the global configuration, and later on it will turn into the configure. So who's able to configure the access? Another action is the access administration interface. That means which user group is able to access a component, for example. Who's able to access the article manager or the banner component. And then we have 5 actions left, and they're mainly focused on the editing of objects. Create, delete, edit, edit state, and edit own. Edit state is, for example, changing an item to featured, yes or no. And edit own is editing the articles the user created themselves. Then we have the group. The group is a collection of users with the same permissions. Once you set permission for the manager group, it will be inherited to the administrator group. So you don't need to set the administrator group, it will be inherited, but you can change it, overrule it if you want. You can completely configure this structure, this tree structure of user groups. But you can also completely remove it besides the public and the super group, the super users. That might be a good idea because that makes it quite complicated for many end users when they start using the Joomla ACL system because of the inheriting between the user groups. And at last we had the access levels. And access levels I already explained, you were using for the menu items, for the articles, for the modules, etc. Those permissions are also inherited. In some documentation on Joomla it said it's not inheriting between the access levels, but actually it does. So when you assign a manager, the administrator group will also be able to see the content. So you don't need to assign the administrator as well. When you don't assign a super user group to an access level, the super user will not be able to see the content. And that's one other main issue at the moment when you allow a user group to log in on the admin of a Joomla, but you don't assign it to the special level in the backend, they will not be able to see the admin menu, for example. That's because the admin is also built of modules, and the default level, access level for the modules on the backend are special. So once you provide a user group access to the backend, you also need to assign it to the super user. So we see everything is turning around the group. You can't assign permissions directly to a user. Even if it's one, you always have to create a user group for that user, and then you assign the permissions to that user group. When you're working with the permissions, we have a kind of 4 different permission settings you can choose of. We have not set, inherited, allowed, and denied. Not set is only available in the global configuration on the highest public level. That's the kind of default state, and that means not allowed, not set. Inherited means inherit the value of the level or user group above. So when it's above, it's not set, it will not be allowed. It will only be allowed, so it's denied by default, and you're only able, a user group is only able to perform action once you allowed a user group. Then we have the denied, and that's only usable when we first have had a allowed before. It's not really useful to set the denied because not set is already a denied. And once we use the denied, you are not able to change it anymore on a nested user group or a lower level. So the denied always win, and that's a very important kind of thing in Joomla 2.5 ACL structure. To see kind of the inheriting between the levels, I always say we have a kind of 4 use permission levels in Joomla. We have one, level 1, the global configuration. There we set the basics. And some actions we can only set in the global configuration, like the login, the admin login, the site login, that's only available at the global configuration, and we won't see that in the component itself anymore because it's site-wide. Then we have level 2, those are the component options, so you can set the permissions for components itself. Then we have level 3, the category, and those are only available for certain components in Joomla. Those are the article manager, for example, the banner, the contact manager. And the last level is the item level. And in Joomla, it's only available for the article manager. Banners are actually also a kind of items, articles, but there are not. It's not possible to set permission for per banner, for example. So once you set an allowed on the highest level, it will be inherited to all levels. But you can also choose to not set it, but only start setting it for a lower level for categories. So a setting is not site-wide. Another time, once you set a denied on the highest level, you will not be able to change it for an item, for example. So when you, for example, set the denied for the delete action on the global configuration, you will not be able to set the delete on allowed for a specific category. It's very important to keep in mind. To make it kind of visible how the inheriting structure works, we have user groups and we have the levels. And once we set, for example, the create action on the global configuration for the manager user group, it inherits two directions. One to the nested administrator group, and the super user is not probably the good name, it's changed later on, so there can be another name. But you see the inheriting goes to the nested user groups, but also to the levels below, to the component and the category. That means that once we deny something for the editor on a component, specific component, the publisher, the nested group of the editor, is not able to create any items as well. But that also works for the categories in that component. So that's also a reason why it's easier to not use nested user groups that much. Because once you get rid of nested group, like administrator in this case, the inheriting only goes one direction. So it's easier to understand where a value is coming from. So this is the kind of basic how the Joomla ACL structure works. It's good to look into that before you start implementing your ACL, otherwise you get totally confused anyway. When we look at the database of the permissions, we see a new table in Joomla 2.5. That's called the assets table. And in this table, all permissions are stored. And it's the only table that's used for it. Of course, we have an ID for the asset, the parent ID, so which permission is the parent of it. We have the left and right values. We have the level, so which level, kind of what I explained earlier, are we talking about. We have a name, a title, and the rules. So let's look more closely at the rules first. When we look at the rule names, we see a kind of default structure for it. We have 10 actions, and they all have their own core login, site, core login, admin, kind of name a structure for saving in the table. The value for the rules can be null, so not set or inherited. It simply doesn't have a specific setting for that permission, or it can be denied, a zero, or a one for allowed, kind of logical. But that's how it get combined into, for example, a JSON encrypted permission. So this is actually saying we have the permission core login site, the action, for user group 6, user group ID 6, it is allowed, and the same for user group ID with ID 2. So this is the way how it is stored in a database. Then we have a kind of naming format as well. That's also a component name. Then we have a kind of section name. We see mostly the category and item in Joomla Core. And we have a kind of ID, and that's equal to the ID of the article itself, or the category, or the component, of not component not, but to the reference article in the actual other tables. So when we look back at it, the names are stored in this column, and the titles can be the component name or the actual article name, for example. That is not that important, but you can use that for the reference. And then we have the JSON encrypted permissions stored in the table as well. We also see that some components don't have permissions. For example, the extension MailTo doesn't have any permission settings. So they're only available for the ones that actually has permissions. Okay, so when you have an extension, basic ACL is a kind of required. In my opinion, basic ACL is based on two actions, configure and access administration. You want to allow people to set which user group is able to access your component, and that's based on the access administration interface. So that sets who is able to go via the component menu to your component. But you need to be able to configure that as well. So the configure action is also needed to set the access. So these two permissions are the kind of minimum requirements for your basic ACO implementation. At the end, the basic ACO implementation is done in 18 lines of code, 4 steps, and a couple minutes of time. Let's walk through the steps. First, you have to modify the config.xml. Normally, there are also the kind of options stored, like how many articles are displayed on a specific page. But you can extend it with the field set for the permissions. And you give this a kind of default base setup. You don't need to change actually anything in here. And here you see the two actions that are basic needed over here. So the core admin with the title, translatable, description, when you hover over and with your mouse you can see the description, the end users, and the other action, that's the core manage. So who's able to access the component. Those are the two you need to add in the config.xml file. The next step is to deny the people who are trying to access the component directly. So there's an access check for that. You check for the user, is it authorized to use the core.manage action, that's the kind of value is stored in the database, for a specific extension. So you change the conf foobar to your extension name. That's actually all is needed to check if a user is able to perform that action, yes or no. So this returns a value, like when it's allowed, it's a 1, and if it's not allowed, it's a 0, so then it will return the error which you are not allowed to access this component directly. So you will put that on top of your first file in your component, just below the restricted line of the component. The next thing is to be able to set those permissions via an option button in the toolbar. So that's the other action. We just had the access, the manage was able to go to the component, and now we need to define to check if the user is able to configure the component. So that's the core.admin. Again, for your extension name, it returns a value, and if you are allowed, the toolbar will render the option button. Just 3 other lines. Then the last line is to make sure your option title is added to your language file. So just one additional language file or line in your language file is needed, so you get your foobar options once you click on it. So this is basically all to implement your basic ACL to your extension. It will result in that when you see in the back over here, there's an option button, and when you click on it, you get the options with the two actions you can set. And now the user is to be able to set which user group is able to access your component. Joomla will take care of the component rendering in the menu. So once a user group doesn't have any access to a component, the component will not show up in the components menu. In my opinion, basic ACL is not the kind of optional thing to implement in your extension. When you build an extension and you're saying you have a native 2.5 extension, it is a requirement to have this. Why? That means that when an end user is not able to use this feature, they are not able to set the permissions for the website. So they can't set up an environment for the end user where only specific components are visible, or only one. When you don't add it, your component will be always visible. Of course, you will probably like that your component is always visible in the menu, but it's not user-friendly at the end. So end users will be very happy when you implement this in your component anyway. And just a few lines of code. So who of the extension developers already implemented the basic ACL? Okay. See some doubts. There are still many extensions out there that don't support this. They're working all kinds of features. At the end, it's just a couple of minutes. So when they don't have this edit, just put a support request to add this. A couple lines, and it's done. Okay, so that's the basic ACL support. But you can, of course, do a lot more with it. The basics are there in Joomla. There are good basics. So how you get use that in your extension. An example. Here we have we create a new access.xml file. And in this file we can define all actions. And as you can see, we have some core actions, but we also add our own action, foobar.delete.own. Joomla doesn't offer an delete own action at the moment, so when you want that in your component, you need to define that in your access.xml file. We can also see there are two sections out here. We have a component section and we have a message section. So we can have several sections where we can define the actions for. So not all actions are simply an option button when you click a big list of it. No, just small groups we can use. We see the kind of naming function. We have the foobar, that's your extension name without the com dot underscore in front of it. So just your extension name, actual extension name, and then we have the action. I also see that some extensions are using the core.admin on the right way, but they start adding their own descriptions. Maybe it's a good idea to simply keep it with the normal thing, so the translation files picking up those descriptions anyway. I also noticed that some extension developers are using core.deleteOwn instead of their own extension name. That's also not the use of it. When you add additional actions, you are not allowed, kind of way, to use the core. That's just for the real core actions at the end. Of course, we need to tell your extension where this new config.xml file is located. Or not actually located, but there are additional actions implemented. So first we had in the config file just the two actions, but when you start adding more, it might be an idea to simply tell there's a field set with permissions for your component, and then it will load the access.xml file in your directory. So this area, this field set is only needed to tell your extension, look, there are actions you have to look up for now in the access.xml file. There are also extensions that really don't get it that well yet. This is an example of it. When you click on the option button, you get a huge list of actions. And this is not all, it continues. This is not very user-friendly. I mean, when the user, end user is looking at it, they totally get lost directly. And it's easily to resolve. Because when we look at the config, the access.xml file, we still see the huge list of all actions listed over here. But if we look closely, we also note that they're kind of reusing the create all the time. Create type, delete type, edit type. That's not that smart because you can use the sections. So you create a section of type and you can simply use the core delete action or the core create actions. You don't need to define a new a rule for each of the actions you have. You can create a section of it and then you start using those types of the actions in it. So really think carefully what kind of action is the kind of create or delete. Just keep it and put it in a section and then you're done. We already saw it before, but the action check. And Joomla offers a very simple way to check if a user group is able to perform an action. You get the user object, you check if it's authorized to for a specific action, so you can change this to any value, also your custom action name for your extension, and then you get the toolbar. So you can do that several times, but it's also a possibility, and we see that also in the Joomla core on several areas, to do a check once. So in this area, we have a kind of variable can-do that's going to the helper. We'll look at the helper in a few moments. And then it's simply checking if can-do get the create action, load the create button, or the edit button, or the delete button, so you can simply loop through those actions and check it. So in the helper, we have the get actions, and we have the ID, possibly. And you can see it's running to the access. And it's first checking, does I have an ID? So do I need to look for a specific message value or for an entire component value? So once there is no value of it, it simply checks the access permission of the component itself. So that's also a kind of fallback. So it uses the general the option set for the component itself and not for the message. Otherwise, when there is a value of the message ID, it will check for the specific, and here we see the naming convention again, of comfoobar message, and then the message ID that is referring to the name in the table for the specific value of that message. And it will loop through each actions the extension has. The JAccess class is checking for all the actions of your component, comfoobar, the component, it loops through it. And for each of the actions, they do the checkup. So you can extend this as well for your specific component to have one kind of big access check. You can also extend this with categories, items, etc. It returns the result, and we use the result back in those in this place to check all the actions specifically. In the great example is also in the default Joomla core for the content example. The same. Checking the content value, is there a category ID or an article ID? If there is no article ID, it is a category, so we look for the category setting. If there is an article ID, we look for the article itself. And again, it's in this case, the actions are defined over here, and then it loops through the actions. So that's just another way to check your actions. Another needed thing is to display the interface to set your permissions for the specific type. It can be an item, can be whatever you have in your extension. Actually, all that's needed is this part. First, there will be a check if you are allowed to set the permission. So again, we see the check again. If you are allowed, this field will be visible. And then it's loop. It gets via the G-form, it gets the rules, and it simply displays the interface we all know over here with the permissions they are found for this specific object. So that's all that's needed to display the interface to set the permission for your extension. Of course, you can create some other interface, already solid, but it's probably better to keep it to the default Joomla interface for now, also for the end user usability, that they don't get confused between all kinds of interfaces. So keep it to the core. How you can use those ACLs in your MVC? Several extensions. We see those checks on all several parts. So first, an example in the model. In the model, you want to check if a user is, for example, able to create the specific article. So over here we check a user, are you able to create for this extension in a specific category with the ID? Yes or no? If the user is not allowed, find the database, throw out an error. You're not allowed. We get an error on the screen. So that's an example in the model. Another one is to only show the articles for a specific user access level. We see it over here. Is the user able to configure this extension? Otherwise, it shows for all other actions, it shows which it get used in the query to get the information to your screen. So that's another way to use the access. Another example in the view of the articles. We see several checks are being done. In the first place, is the user able to create, to edit, to manage, to edit own, to edit the state? And we also see that's using several extensions. For example, is a user able to check it in via the component check-in? So we have all this information, we load this, and then we start building our grid with related to these results of it. Are they allowed to do it? Are they allowed to see it? So we display the information we want. If a user is able to edit or is able to edit their own, then we show a linked title. Otherwise, we show simply only the title, so you can't click on it, and that's it. So this is the way to kind of display which information is related for your user, yes or no. We still had to prevent that when they know the direct URL, that they are not able to access it directly. So you're not solving it by hiding it in your view. You also need to prevent it via your controller and in the model for certain things. So another example in the view for the table display, are they able to change the ordering and save the ordering? Then we show the ordering clicks, so you can click on it to change the order of the articles in your view. Otherwise, we simply show it, but disabled, so you can't click on it, just for viewing. And at last, we have the controller. Again, the same kind of check. Are you able to edit the state of it? And it's in this case, it loops through the checks for each of the items in there. So in this case, we want to set several items to featured. So we want to change the state of it, featured or yes or no. And it loops for each article through it and set it. It checks if you're allowed to change the state of it. So for some, you will probably able to do it, for some not. And you will be get an error for the ones you were not allowed to change the state of it. So that's in the controller. As we can see, it's always kind of used the same simple way. So actually, it is not that complicated. It's always simply checking, and depending on what needs to be done or visible, it will be visible or you will not allow to perform the action. So at the end, Joomla has a very simple thing, just this check, and it's up to you how you start using it. And be creative on it. In most of the extensions, you can start implementing some more features for your end users. For example, when you have several forms in your you have a form extension and you have your user is able to create several forms, you might want to think about which user group is able to edit or view the submission of which form. It's easily implement. Add your own actions for it and start configure it. Another example, download components. You can also use this same system. We now have quite a lot of extensions that are using their own permission system. Kind of logical, because the one in 1.5 was not flexible. But it's maybe now time to start slowly moving that back to Joomla. And a good example is now that there's an eDocman. That's a forked version of Docman. That is, instead of using the old Docman permission system, now using purely the core system, by extending several actions and allowed to be it visible. There are several good references on the internet to look in more detail when you start implementing it. Here are the URLs that will be also clickable in the slideshow, so you can start looking at it and work it for your own extensions. So thank you. Any questions or any about your implementation of ACL in your extension?
Since you brought up the ACL manager, I think you're not satisfied with the UI. So I'd like to see the alternative. How the ACL manager will manage all that.
Okay, so how the ACL manager displaying the additional actions, or?
I understand how I manage permissions in the call.
Yeah.
I'd like to see how ACL manager intends to improve that.
Okay, so I can bring up the ACL manager screen. Let's see. So actually, one of the most difficult things for the end users. Is that you can set the permission on so many locations. The global configuration for each component, when you have 20 categories, you can set it for 20 times. When you have in each category, you have 10 articles, there it's really growing. There is an option actually to see it in Joomla itself, the core, the overview, but you had to turn on the debug mode for it. When you go to the global configuration and you set the debug mode, let's see, where is it? System. And when you go back to the groups, there will be a new button visible, debug permission report. And it's only visible when you turn the debug mode on. And once you click on that, you get a kind of overview of all the values. But the very disadvantage of this way is that you always need to turn on the debug mode. And we all know what happened. We got a lot of information on the website. So when you have a live site, it's not really wanted that you turn on the debug mode all the time to see what the users are actually doing. So ACL manager is able to show for a user group or a user which permission are set. We also can see which specific action are set on which area. So this with the green background for this action, for this level, is actually really set. When it's get inherit, and this is a bad example because there's no... it's normally, it's just a green check. So, oh yeah, think. You see, this is the actual value, the actual setting, and this get inherited. So that's a kind of one overview for the users that makes it easier to understand where are my settings coming from. And of course, there's an option to see it per user as well. When an extension like the GC editor has additional actions, you see it as well in the overview for the user. User can click on the names, and then it show up. Or for categories, they get redirected to the Joomla category to set the permissions. So I have one over here. Go downstairs to set the permission. This is public group. No, anyway, doesn't matter that much. And you get redirected back directly to. Okay. Live demo. Okay, and this time it doesn't work. Normally, you get redirected to the overview again. And you see the actual change. One of the difficult things is that for the end users, it's still not. Yeah, one of the big changes we probably need to do in Joomla is to make it more easy to simply click, for example, on actions and change the value. And one of the other things that I noticed, due to the basic L support that is missing, that you can't set the permission. So a lot of users are complaining, yeah, I have a kind of configuration, I want to set access to one component, for example, so you can really create a customized backend for the end user, and that's not possible. I temporarily solved that, meanwhile, waiting all extension updated their extensions, by being able to set the permissions anyway via ACL manager. So it's not required that, for example, in this case, Zoo doesn't have any ACL support. So you can anyway set the basic actions. But as well, Zoo could be probably create a lot of great features out of it by give access to certain apps that work with the app system. So that's our possibilities for them to work with the Joomla ACL system. And the reason why they probably don't do it, they won't have one package for 1.5 and 2.5. So I think that's their reason. Another thing that's going quite wrong at the moment is that a lot of migrated websites messing up the assets table totally. The parent values are wrong, the levels are wrong. So you think you understand the permission system, but at the end it doesn't work and you don't get it by. So I recently built in a check that's able to detect those issues by looking at the normal content table. What is the level? What is the parent item? Which category is located? And you can fix it with a click to get it all right. It's also missing when extensions just don't have a reference in the assets table. The permissions don't work either. That's also able to check. And it's also able to check when you have set the admin login for user group, but you didn't assign the user to the specific level needed to view the menu. That's also detecting now. And that will probably extend it with other checks. Does that maybe bit answer your question? Yeah? Other questions? Yeah, for sure. You can do those checks at the front end as well for user groups. So you can use that in your. You can probably also create view. Another thing that might be interesting for Joomla is to merge the access level simply to a view action. At the end, it's also a kind of action that we get rid of one area of the ACL, and it's simply a view, so you can define it even more easier for your front-end users. But so you can, the views are of course a kind of different thing, but the actions, yeah, you can use that for sure in the front-end. so you can also use your interface on the front end. But I also see that several components are now focusing again on the back end, because it's now able to set a back end to one component. So in some cases, it might be better instead of via the front end, do it via the back end, but now easier because you log in, you only see one component and not a whole bunch of settings. Other questions? Okay, I will be around, of course, for the rest of the day. So when you have any specific question,
You are maybe the most prominent guy working on ACL in the community right now. What is your feedback? Do the people understand that concept?
They start.
Let me add that. Mm-hmm. It depends on the administrator of the website whether or not he implemented correctly.
Yeah.
You know, setting up the right groups, whatever. You can put whatever in your code on the component side. If the super user doesn't set up the site correctly.
Yeah.
Your experience?
My experience that people are, in the last months, are really start using the ACL more and more. At 1.6, people are really looking, what is this ACL all about? But they really start using it, and really, for especially like the feature, you can only give permission to one certain component in the backend. That's really helpful for a lot of websites, and also you can create a user group that's all only able to access the data form or whatever. So when I think people are getting it more and more nowadays, but are now kind of waiting on we as a community, as extension developers, to start being creative on implementing that as well. I also see that now we have to. I like the basics of Joomla, the ACL. It's really usable in your extension. We might work on the usability of it. That's something I already discussed with Kyle as well. For maybe 3.0, we can look how can we improve the usability of it. And I really noticed recently that people are now starting to ask very good question via my support as well. For example, I would like to be able to provide access to one module only. At the moment, it's entire module manager or none. So another quite request is the menu, for example. You have several menus, you only be able to access one menu to make changes, and not all the menu, and even the menu items. So that means for me that people are starting to using it, and now see new issues coming up, and that means that people are kind of adapting it, in my opinion. And we now need to make the next steps to get that quite well. And yeah, the general feedback, once people start understanding the ACL system, how it works with the denied, that's complicated, the inheriting system is complicated, but they really like it. So, okay. So when you have any question regarding your custom extension or any advice needed, just speak to me later on or email me or whatever, and I really hope that we start creating cool stuff based on ACL in your own extension. And I'm looking for good examples as well. So when you know an extension that is using already the ACL in a nice way, more than just the basic access stuff, I really would like to know it. So thank you.